Hey guys, and welcome back to our channel Anime Explained. Today's video we want to talk about a pretty basic concept in Tokyo Ghoul, which is what are ghouls? Ghouls are carnivorous and cannibalistic humanoid species that are only able to feed on the flesh of humans and other ghouls. They are unable to digest any other type of food due to a particular enzyme their bodies produce. The structure of their tongues is also different from humans, making other foods taste disgusting and uncomfortable. If they do consume human food, their condition will deteriorate and they will often become ill. While ghouls cannot eat normal food, they are, however, able to drink coffee and eat the beans, as well as regular drinking water. Ghouls do not need to eat as often as a regular human. They can survive for long periods, 1 to 2 months, on a single human body. When a ghoul enters an extreme state of hunger, they will suffer very painful headaches and their mental ability will be impaired, causing them to become driven by instinct alone. They will feed on any available source of human meat to end the state, even that of close friends. Ghouls have a high physical capability and are 4 to 7 times stronger than the average human. They are able to send the average human flying if struck with enough force, and can penetrate a human's body with their bare hands. They are also capable of jumping to heights not achievable by a regular human. Their bodies are extremely resistant to injury. Ghouls possess an organ called the cacao, which the kagane is formed. The kagane is a hard, muscle-like protrusion described as their claws. It can take the form of a pair of sharp wings, tentacle-like appendages, a tail, or a blade-like object, and can even be detached from the ghoul, depending on certain factors. Ghouls have an identifying feature known as a kakugan, an affliction manifesting in the eyes as red irises surrounded by a black sclera. A ghoul's kakugan can either appear by their own will, due to hunger, or when using their kagane. While ghouls prefer to consume humans, it is not uncommon for them to cannibalize one another. Ghoul tissue is considered disgusting, but eating ghoul tissue does have the advantage of providing an alternative food source. Additionally, cannibalism can increase a ghoul's RC level, the cells responsible for the formation of the kagane, to the point where an armor-like kagane forms alongside the predatory kagane that ghouls commonly possess, turning them into kakujas. In terms of lifestyle, ghouls had two options. They could live as hermits, isolated and avoiding society's eyes, or they could attempt to assimilate into human society. Other than the standard two-eyed ghoul, there were a couple variants. The first is the one-eyed ghoul, a rare human-ghoul hybrid, either created artificially or naturally born between interspecies relationships. Quinks are examples of artificial one-eyed ghoul variants. There were also half-humans, which were human-ghoul hybrids born without ghoul abilities. Lastly, as mentioned previously, there were also kakujas, which were ghouls whose RC cells have mutated and developed an armor-like kagane through repeated cannibalism. We will go into more of these variations in another video. And there you have it! Do you know anything else about ghouls? Let us know down below in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel so we can continue making them for you. Thanks for tuning in!